Hey, it's Pete's Dude Man. I'm gonna go ahead and get started a little even earlier than usual here, just because it actually is getting kind of late. And also, I haven't played Splatoon since the last Splatfest, and I know there's a lot of updates to the game, so I'm sure there's gonna be a lot I have to sit through, and I have to really basically learn how to do some stuff because I haven't played this game in forever. Hold on to your tentacles! It's Englobulous News time. Would you rather roast a marshmallow or a hot dog? Well, hopefully the video title makes it obvious. Head over to the pledge box and vote. We've got some update information to share. I love updates. Me too. The stage selection has been expanded. Oh, sweet. I still never even played Moray Towers. God, Camp Triggerfish? Now there'll be even more variety in the rotation. Booyah! More weapons are now available. Yeah, I've read like 40. Do I have to click through all these? Oh god. Oh god. Oh, sweet. Now there's only three. We'll need to ask Sheldon for the deets. She was so disappointed when she says that. Like, we gotta go talk to Sheldon. Like, oh my god. New gear's been added. I'm all out of cash. How are you? You're an idol. Idols don't run out of cash. They can just ask for more. Oh boy. Anything else? Let's unveil the current Splatfest battle stages. What do we got? I hope I get some new stuff. Black Billy Skate Park. Okay, I'm used to this one. Camp Triggerfish. Okay, I'll get to try that one out. That also looks familiar from the story mode. All right. And Moray Tower. Oh! I've always wanted to do Moray Towers, so cool. I'll get. I like that I have two new stages and one that I've never and one that I'm used to. That'll be nice. Okay. What is this shirt I have on? Is this just like? Is this my? Well, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna go change my shirt anyway for Splatfest. Alrighty. So, video title to make it obvious, I'm on Team Marshmallow. I would rather roast a marshmallow. That's just. I mean, I've roasted some hot dogs in my life, but that was always the thing, was you go on camping. I did a lot of camping. You go camping, you roast a marshmallow. That's my experience, anyway. So,
Anyways, bratwursts are
marshmallow.
sexier than hot dogs.
Join. Marshmallow team,
Do we have a bratwurst team? I want the bratwurst.
No,
And beer.
they're not, there's no Germany.
I want beer. Give me beer.
All right, so there. I'm on Team Marshmallow, which I guess we're red this time. Red versus green. It's Christmas. Should have saved that color scheme for Christmas. All right, Sheldon, what do you have now? I think I saw a new brush, so we'll keep with the tradition of trying out a new brush.
Oh, your brush is cool, though.
I'm looking fairly fresh, so I can try a slosher, which is a totally new weapon type. I did read up a little bit about it. I have no idea what it does. Fling a large amount of ink directly ahead. Okay. That's kind of cool. And the heavy splatling is a whole new weapon class. Wait, I need to read this. Hold ZR to press. Hold ZR to pressurize the ink and then release it to splatterize your foes. Like. But it uses a lot of ink. Okay. Interesting. Neo Splash-O-Matic. Yeah. And the ink brush. No. Ooh, what is that? Ink mines? Oh, it has the bubbler? Oh, cool! I can't wait to try that ink brush. Oh my god, there's so many weapons. Oh wait, no, I don't want to buy that. So there's a new ink brush that has trip mines and bubblers. That'll be fun. Yeah, I'll buy that. Yeah, I'll equip that. I still haven't found a weapon that I like more than just the good old crack-on splat roller, but that's probably just because I've played with that weapon so much that I'm just so used to it. But I like trying out the new weapons. Alrighty. What time is it? It's right at 4 p.m. when I said I would start. So, good time to start. Let's go for it. We got our weapon, we got our team. I just haven't played this game in a really long time, so we'll see how it goes. Oh, snap! You made it to level 20. All right, I heard the level cap increased. New levels are now available, but leveling works a little different from here on. Oh, really? In regular battles, you'll get 1 point for inking 200 points of turf or 2 for 400. And winning the battle will earn you an additional 3. You'll need as many points as possible to raise that level, so play to win. In ranked battles, you'll get 1 point for each minute your team survives. A standard win will bag you an extra 3. You'll get those points for surviving if you lose, so don't give up. And if you win by knockout, you'll get a whopping 10. Okay, you'll still earn cash the same way as before, but go see Judd every 5 levels and he'll hook you up with a reward. Okay. If you participate in online battles, your game stats may be published in the game and online. Oh, okay. All right. And then, yes, I did read about this, that there are private battles now, and I might play around with that later, because my friends Rex and Lance recently got the game, and my brothers had the game, so there we got a team of 4 right there. So that's something that we might do in the future, but right now, it's time for Splatfest! Da-na-na-na! Marshmallows! Da-na-na-na! They're really good and sugary and bad for you. But yeah, no, I'm a real, like, sweet tooth. I eat lots of, wow, look at these people already above level 20. Well, I have no idea how recent that update is. But, like, no, there's been lots of times where, like, Rosie made me a bunch of cookies and then they were gone in an hour. I think that's happened 2 or 3 times. I don't know. I like my sugar. I'm not, like, Gaius level sugar, but I'm close-ish. I don't know.
Your diabetes level sugar.
First death battle of the stream. Oh, great. Despicable Me 1 versus Despicable Me 2 versus the minions. I can't judge the minions because I haven't seen it. Between Despicable Me 1 and 2, I think 1 is much better. Actually, my dad and I were talking about this over this last week about which Despicable Me was better. And, we like Despicable Me 1 better because Gru is just a much more interesting character in Despicable Me 1. In Despicable Me 2... You know, when he's not evil anymore, he's just not funny anymore. So, we have to say Despicable Me 1. I haven't seen Minions, but, I mean, it doesn't have Gru. How can I like it? It doesn't have Gru in it. I can't hear anything. Why can I not hear anything? Huh. Normally, I can still hear, like, the game through my headphones on the gamepad, but right now I cannot hear anything. This is the Moray Towers, huh? Gotcha. I'm liking this stage already. I thought I would like this stage, and I do. Right. I got Bubbler and Trip Mines. Okay. That was a burst. Oh, that was not mine. Where's the... I can't use it? Okay. Oh, whoa! Something just happened on my TV. I think my capture card just kind of freaked out. Looks like it's still working, though, so I'll keep going. I don't know why it freaked out like that. And it looks like the stream's still running too. I've gotten into, right, I actually like keep the stream up on my thing so I can make sure that it's still working. I thought that'd be too much of a strain on my computer, and it might have been on my old computer, but I have a new computer now, and it seems to work out pretty good. I can like keep on, I can do both and multitask on it better. So this is a more, this is a thinner paintbrush than the one I was using before. So, it's not that giant thick paintbrush. It's more like the thin one. Oh, you can tell by the style too, can't you? Okay. Oh, that's a trip mine. Ha ha! But I don't know why I can't hear the game. I thought... Maybe I'm wrong. I thought that if you plug the headphones into the gamepad, you can hear the game. Maybe not. Maybe I'm remembering wrong. I don't remember. I am going to miss having my crack on Splat Roller. Uh-oh. Oh, didn't survive, though. Who do you think is a better character for Smash? Birdo, King Boo, Petey Piranha, or Count Black? A better character for Smash Brothers? Ooh, boy. From a character standpoint... Okay, first of all, from a moveset standpoint, right, they all have plenty of moves to work with. From a character selection standpoint, Classic me would say Petey Piranha. Petey Piranha is such, I think, at this point, a really iconic boss. You see him appear in a lot of ways, in a lot of forms, in a lot of Mario games. I really like Count Black, and I think Burrow makes a lot of sense, and King Boo would be awesome, but I think Petey Piranha is the most well-established. Although, I do, boy, I don't know, now that I say that, I think King Boo might be better because he has such a bigger role. He's been the main antagonist of a couple games. So you know what? I'm totally going to change my mind and say King Boo. I'm going to totally change my mind and say King Boo. I remember when I was doing, like, speculation type stuff on Smashboards and stuff, I had an idea for how King Boo would work, too. Instead of having jumps, what happens is when you press the up button, he just hovers and starts, you know, floating upward. And as he does that, his body shrinks. And once it's reached a certain size and it becomes small, he can't fly anymore. And that's when he starts falling. And that'll automatically start slowly recharging while he's on the ground. So that was my idea for how King Boo works mechanically. Oh, hey, this is the other one. New stage, Camp Triggerfish. So actually, yeah, I'm gonna wait. We're orange now. Oh, can we actually have different colors now for the Splatfest? Oh, okay. It's not red and green each time, huh? Wow. Actually, I don't know if I know this stage at all. Is this the one where you? Oh gosh, I don't remember. I'm just exploring right now. Okay. Oh, the slosh is like a bucket? Oh, that's really cool, actually. I like that. Okay, let's get the bubbler ready. Come on, just a little more. Alright, got it just in time. Oh, shit! I was just about to use it! Oh, man. All right, let's get. Oh, he got me? I thought it was far enough away. Well, darn. I can't see the chat very well. One second, I need to fix that. Okay, there we go. Crud. Someone is sloshing it up there. Okay, there's no way to get across that way. I got my bubbler charged for when I can use it. Just gotta not lose it. Oh, I should've used my bubbler. Fine. Okay. Count Black versus Beerus? How would Count Black possibly defeat Beerus? There's no way. Beerus. I never even get to use my bubbler! God damn it. Okay, how are we doing? Looking at the map, it looks even-ish to me. But I'm not so used to this map yet. Alright. Oh. Hey! Oh. Gotcha, Chloe. Chalohe. Alright, let's just kind of speed through, cover lots of turf, and get our bubbler up. Okay, we can finally use it once. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, enemy. Hello! Oh, Inkbrush! Oh, shit! Fuck! Oh, they won. They totally won. Oh, crap. Well, damn. Oh, that's what that stage is shaped like. Okay. Oh, man, I lost! Oh, what a disappointment. Okay. Can I level up off of this mode? Okay, I see. Did I only get 1 point for the last one? That sucks. How'd I do that? I've never only gotten 1 point before. I didn't even know that was possible. Marshmallow fiend, marshmallow fanboy. Wow, we're playing with a guy named God Squid. That's amazing. God Squid. But like I said, I haven't played this game since the last Splatfest, so I'm very rusty. I actually haven't done anything in a while. I mean, I know on my main channel, my YouTube channel, I still have Pokemon XD episodes going up every day, but that's because I just like pre-recorded those a long time ago, because I just got back from a vacation in Las Vegas. So I haven't done anything in a very long time. As far as the YouTube stuff's concerned, because of course, I mean, I haven't done any of those Fire Emblem videos since I did the initial Robins. I'm hoping to finally get Long Queue up this week. I was going to try to get it done before I left for Vegas, but it didn't work out. So, I don't know, I'm hoping to have that up on Wednesday or Thursday, or maybe even Tuesday. We'll see. Because Long Queue is by far the most voted one to be done next. So, Long Queue's top 5 S-Supports video will be the next top 5 S-Supports video. Okay, we must be at the camp again, because it's so much I don't recognize. Actually, now I think that I don't think I was ever able to hear the game through the headphones before. A lot of times when I'm recording, what the hell? Oh, it's not all the way plugged in. That's my problem. Oh, now I can hear it. Jesus, that's what it was. My headphones weren't plugged in all the way. Got it. Now I can hear the game. Hello there. Oh, are you kidding me? Damn. You're a kid, you're a squid, you're a god. The legendary Squid God. The ultimate power-up that can still not defeat Superman. Oh, shit. What a bunch of assholes. Okay, no, I'm just kidding. Alright, you know what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna stay up here and be like, ha-ha-ha! Yeah, how do you like that? Huh? Huh? Oh, crap, I'm out of ink. All right, there we go. Oh yeah, I'm glad I must have been able to hear it before because I always mentioned how cool the song was. The gates are down. What gates? But yeah, usually when I'm recording these types of videos, unless I can hear the game through like the gamepad. I have to have the volume low on the TV so that it doesn't bleed into the mic. So I normally can't hear the game. Like if I'm doing something on my Wii or GameCube or Xbox, I can't hear the game at all. But I can hear the ones on Wii U sometimes if they have the sound through the gamepad, which not all of them do. Some games like I've done like Don't Starve. Even if you plug the headphones in, that you actually still can't, you can't hear the sound. Or actually, I think you can, but it turns off the sound on the TV, so then you guys wouldn't be able to hear the sound. I'm like, well, I want the sound to be on the video. So, of course they're gonna do it that way. I don't even know who's winning. I'm pretty sure it's them, though. Alright. Hi, do you swear a lot? Is that a problem? I can tone it down. I've been thinking recently that maybe I should try to swear less on these videos. Alright, what other comments we got here? Dr. Octopus vs. Frieza? There's no way Dr. Octopus stands a chance. Frieza? But, I mean, there's no reason that I have to swear. Like, I'm used to not swearing because I have two very young brothers, and I work as an elementary school teacher, and while I'm working, I don't swear, obviously, that would be really bad. I don't know. I always feel like, okay, when I'm on my own time and doing my own thing, I should be able to, you know, talk unfiltered. But, I mean, like I said, there's no reason I have to swear, and there are some people who really get, you know, turned off by that and are like, oh, I can't watch you or I don't want to watch you if you're swearing. So I've been really, really heavily considered toning it down recently. And actually, if you watch my Punch-Out LP, like, of course, my videos before that, yeah. But if you watch my Punch-Out LP, if I remember correctly, I don't swear at all during that. So that's something I've been putting into consideration. I don't know. Like, even if I did, I wouldn't, like, totally, like, filter myself. If there's a situation I'm in where I just, like, it comes out, it comes out. I'm not gonna be like, oh, shoot, I'm so sorry, guys. But I don't know. A lot of times, I just kind of play it up for laughs, and I don't have to. Alright, are we both red this time? Wait a minute! We're Marshmallow versus Marshmallow! What? Why are we Marshmallow versus Marshmallow? I think something is wrong. Didn't it just say we were both Team Marshmallow? What? Are there just so few people on Team Hot Dog that they have to have two teams of Marshmallow? What just happened? Oh, man. I can just picture it. Hey kids, time to learn a new word. It's called... Well, the thing is, though, I'm a music teacher, so usually words are not as relevant. You know, it's not like I'm teaching vocabulary. I mean, besides music-related vocabulary. So, yeah. Kids learn words like forte, and piano, and ritardando, and quarter notes. Ah, darn it! I'm never fast enough to press the bubbler button. Spider-Man versus Little Mac? I gotta say Spider-Man. I mean, Little Mac's a great boxer and all, but I mean, if they're in a more open arena and Spider-Man's got his webbing and Spidey sense, then how is Matt gonna land any hits? Oh my gosh! Wow, that thing kills really fast. Wow. Little Mac versus Little Mac? Little Mac. That was an easy one. Ah, shoot. I think I gotta switch back onto my splat roller. I don't like the thin brushes. I like the octo brush because it's a bit thicker. These thin brushes are just, they can't compare to like anything else. Who's your favorite Punch-Out character? Boy. Bear Hugger's pretty entertaining. I'm not gonna lie. See, look at that. If I had any other physical weapon besides the ink brush, would have killed that guy. Once we get up to Marshmallow Fiend, I'm going to switch back to the Crack-On Splat Roller. We lost. We totally lost. Look at all that blue. Well, I guess Team Marshmallow won. Oh, darn. Was that just like a visual glitch? Was it actually a Team Hot Dog? Or did we seriously just go up against... We went up against another Marshmallow team. Victory, Team Marshmallow. Defeat, Team Marshmallow. What? Disco Kid? You know what? I do like Disco Kid, but I didn't before. Really, while I was doing the LP and everyone was commenting about Disco Kid and all the stuff, I came to like him more. But prior to that, oh, I just thought he was annoying. I just like, oh god, why? Who thought this character was a good idea? Oh well. Oh, hello.
Give us your cash!
I don't know, I'm just checking out the other stuff here. I mean, this straw boater is pretty nifty. Alright, we're gonna switch to the Crack-On Splat Roller. Bald Bull? I like Bald Bull. Crack-On Splat Roller. I mean, Bald Bull is pretty much the most recurring character. Because not only is he in, like, every Punch-Out, I believe, but he's also in the Punch-Out spin-off game, Arm Wrestling. So, I mean, he's just always there, you know?
Boxercise!
Yeah, that's right.
Boxercise!
Maybe we'll actually fight against some hot dogs this time, huh? So what is the level cap for Splatoon now, anyway? Splatoon... new level cap. I'm not seeing anything on it, just by Google searching it immediately, so if any of you guys know what the new Splatoon level cap is, let me know, because I'd love to know. $50? Okay. Aaron Ryan is probably my favorite character to beat up, because, I mean, I don't know, he and Super Macho Man are both really fun to beat up, but Aaron Ryan just, like, it's just like, ah! I don't know, I don't even know how to explain it, it's just, it's really fun to beat him up. You know those people in your life who are just really fun to beat up? Wow, I forgot how, okay, now I'm suddenly like, oh wow, this is really slow. But it just has such a clearer role. You know you can use it to kill people. And you're like, look at all this turf I can cover. I know I'm slow, but look at all this turf I can cover. Gotcha. The ink brushes are cool, but I think more than anything, I'm so used to the rollers now. I just played with them so much that, because, I mean, I don't know, man, I had to really get good with the roller to do those roller challenges on the amiibo. Those were crazy. And I always like having something with the Kraken. So, probably after the Crack-On Splat Roller, my favorite weapon is the Octobrush, since it comes with Kraken. See, look at this. I'm like can cover the entire road with this roller. Wow, did they like? I went a long time without refueling ink. I think they might have made it a little slower. I don't know. I can't tell. All right, we're actually, for once, it actually makes sense to jump because we're advancing really fast. Ah! Gotcha. I am starting to miss the speed at which I can fling my Octobrush out, but the power of this thing makes up for it. Because I can hit an enemy like 3 times with my brush, they won't die. If I hit them with once with this, usually they do. Let's get what we can. I think they're shooting at me. I can't tell there because their aim is so horrible. Hey there! Where do you think you're going? Get back here, you!
Ha 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 Yes! Oh my god, see, look how much better I'm doing with the roller. I gotta stick to this weapon. That's way more points and way more deaths than I was ever doing with any brush.
Did you already hear that the Squid Girl gear is out, Pizza? What do you mean, Squid Girl gear? Squid Girl gear? I have no idea what you're talking about. So, obviously, I haven't heard about this. You have to explain it to me. Alright, we won, totally.
It's all because I switched my rollers, guys. That's why we won. Stick to your guns, or in this case, rollers.
Oh man, I got MVP too. MVP pizza! Dude, I got 8 kills? Jesus. Why did I ever switch weapons? Ability unlocked!
Right, because I got a new,
Oh, hey, that's, duration, isn't it? Or is that recharge time? Recharge time. Okay, never mind.
There's a 3-part gear set where you can dress up like a Squid Girl.
Oh, from the anime! Really? That's awesome! I didn't know that. I think because they did a crossover, like, manga, which was awesome, that they did that. I didn't hear there was an outfit. Oh, that's cool.
Elsa versus Spider-Man? Elsa versus Spider-Man, huh? I'm going to say Spider-Man because I believe he is more trained to use his powers for combat.
I like this game, so I will sub to you. Oh, thank you so much. No Little Mac versus Luigi. Oh, Little Mac versus Luigi. Little Mac versus Luigi, huh? I'm going to say... Winston, probably... boy. It depends on the conditions of the fight, but if we are going with the whole, oh, they can use everything that they have, probably Luigi, because Mario and Luigi have so much gear. And Little Mac's a great boxer and a great fighter and all, but faced with all those things they can do, oh, they can fly, oh, they have this, oh, they have that, I just don't see how they're going to win a death battle.
I didn't want to use my Kraken yet, but I thought I was going to die, so... Now he is the one who is dead. Come back here, you! Why did I do that? That was really dumb of me. Oh, I can't believe I did that.
Okay, so this is the final list of Mario characters for my new Smash roster. Mario, Luigi, Captain Toad, Geno, Mallow, Peach, Daisy, Rosalina, Bowser, Bowser Jr., King Boo, Fawful, Paper Mario. What do you think?
It looked... I mean... That's a really cool list. The one thing I would say, I don't know if you're counting Waluigi as a Mario character or a Wario character, but if you're gonna have Daisy in there, I think you should also have Waluigi. Because then that's like the one, like, okay, this character appears in like all these games that you're missing.
First tournament match on Monday, you ready?
Okay, sure. That's from Lord Jackal. I guess we're doing we're doing a Splatoon tournament. I totally forgot. I just got back from Vegas, so I have to readjust here. So okay, on Monday, sure. Although I'm gonna lose like horribly because I haven't played this game much. How did they get up here? Go away! Stupid suction bombs. There we go. Okay, let's start grounding up this turf.
We're playing a French team? Who's on our team? Are we the American team? Waluigi is along with DK, Wario, Yoshi. Okay, perfect then. That is like the perfect ultimate Mario character roster.
I'm trying to think if anything's really missing from it. No, I think you covered pretty much every aspect. So, yeah. Like you were saying, like, Birdo and Petey Piranha would be good other picks to go in there, but...
All right.
We're the only Americans in the tournament? Okay. Who is the weakest character in Nintendo? Someone already responded with Goomba, and that sounds pretty accurate. I'm trying to think if there's anything weaker than a Goomba. You know what is weaker than a Goomba is a Cheep Cheep out of water. Because if you ever find Cheep Cheeps out of water in Super Mario World, all you have to do to kill them is touch them, like you have a star. The team is going to be you, me, Brady, and Brian. Okay. Magikarp's the weakest thing in Nintendo? No. No, because they at least can tackle. Goombas don't even really do that. I mean, some Goombas do. They more of just kind of saunter, though. You know what I mean? I mean, they also tackle, but Magikarps can learn flail and bounce. Although there are some Goombas that can head bonk, and that's pretty good. Maybe a Goomba is tougher than a Magikarp. Although Magikarps have HP, well, Goombas usually only take one hit, and even if a Goomba does have HP, it's usually only two. So, it's a good question. Cheep Cheep become giant Cheep. Oh, we're talking about... Okay. So, while I was in Las Vegas, I saw two shows. The first one was called Ka, which was a Cirque du Soleil. Which, if you don't know what a Cirque du Soleil is, I didn't really either. Hey, we're against another marshmallow team? Again? What's your favorite game? Super Smash Brothers.
Totally.
Super Smash Brothers. So a Cirque du Soleil is basically an acrobatic show, but it has some sort of theme and a lot of times follows a story. It's just expressed entirely through acrobatics. And it has, at least these ones in Vegas, has really, really extensive, like, costumes and props and backdrops, like every show in Vegas. As far as I can tell, they don't have dialogue. I don't know if there's any Cirque du Soleils that do have dialogue, but Ka did not. Ka was pretty much, it was kind of like, as far as I can tell, it was kind of the Asian-themed Cirque du Soleil. It was about, like, I don't know, they seemed like kind of mixed between Chinese and Japanese. Prince and princess who are twins and become separated and go on different journeys against evil ninjas to reclaim their throne after their father gets killed by these ninjas. That's what I got out of it. It was really it was super impressive. Very impressive acrobatics. Like, man, there was this one guy who was like running on this wheel in midair and like jumping off of it, and he would like jump off with a jump rope and then do multiple like jump rope spins in the air. Whoa, I've never had that happen before. Because I mean, when you have a game like this that has more players on one team, you're going to get more of the, I don't want to say bad players, but newer, inexperienced, or younger players, too. Because that's what makes up the bigger, I think, amount of players on this game in general. But that's just my guess. But there must be way more marshmallows, because I've had this, that was my second marshmallow versus marshmallow fight. And I'm doing another one here. Who would you want in Super Smash Brothers? I made a top 10 most wanted characters in Super Smash Brothers video My number one on there is King K. Rool. I think in general, right, I mean, we have seen, you know, we pretty much have, we have all the Mario characters that we really, really need. We have all the Legend of Zelda characters. We have all the, we have plenty of Pokemon, even though there's a lot of other Pokemon that would also still really work. There's, we have plenty of Pokemon characters. We've seen all the main Kirby characters. We've seen a lot of Star Fox characters. Why do we only have Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong for Donkey Kong characters? We've had entire Donkey Kong games with full rosters of characters, like Donkey Kong 64 and Donkey Kong Barrel Blast and Diddy Kong Racing. There are so many good Donkey Kong characters to work with, but we only have Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong. That's like if they only had Mario and Luigi for the Mario characters. Which, I mean, they did back in the original Super Smash Brothers, but now we see have these full fleshed out character rosters for each big game, except for we only have the bare minimum for Donkey Kong characters. It's like, where are Dixie Kong and King K. Rool and possibly others? I think it's ridiculous. But that's just me. And, well, it's not just me, because there's a lot of people who think that too. So, by far, my most wanted character is King K. Rool. Because I think there are a lot of Donkey Kong characters that would work well, but King K. Rool is my favorite. Because he's the villain, and I like being able to play as the villain. It's like a rare treat. You know what I mean? So, yeah. King K. Rool is by far my most wanted. I would love to see a playable Ridley, although it looks like, there's quite an opposition to that. There's a lot of support for it, too, but it also has a very vocal opposition. Even though there's already a lot of Pokemon, I really like the idea of Meowth. And that's the same, I like Toad for Mario, just because, gosh, Meowth and Toad, there's two characters that have been with the series forever and have a big role to the series, but are not playable in Smash Brothers yet. And nothing against them, because there's lots of more interesting Mario and Pokemon characters, but it's like, you know, Toad is playable in a lot of games, and Meowth is one of the few Pokemon with a consistent role, and yet there's, you know, they're not there. Wow, we are dominating this map. We are destroying Team Marshmallow as Team Marshmallow. This doesn't really matter. I'm trying to remember who else was on my list. I mean, I do remember, but those are like the big ones that I'm thinking about right now. Gotcha. 3, 2, 1, we win! Totally, I mean, oh my god, we just rocked that. Oh, whoa, lots of comments, mainly from Lord Jackal. Okay, I'm Team Marshmallow, I've been fighting my own team all day. Here's my Zelda character lineup. Link, Young Link, Zelda, Sheik, Impa, Midna, Lana, Ganondorf, School Kid, Girahim, Toon Link, Tetra, and Vaadi. I kind of got to agree with Lord Jackal. Tingle has his own series. I think he's a pretty big character. I would, personally, looking at your Legend of Zelda character list, I would put in Tingle over Lana. But that's just me. But besides that, you pretty much cover everything, including characters I don't really care about, like Girahim and Vaadi. So, it's good. I'm still under the belief that if you add Girahim, you might as well add Zant, because he is also a one-time Zelda villain who, in my opinion, was much more interesting than Girahim. But, once again, it's just me. Girahim seems to have this giant following that Zant didn't, and I don't understand why. And Girahim was funny and all, but so was Zant. And then, between the two, Zant actually had his own agenda and ideas as a villain, while Girahim was just a sword. In both the literal and metaphorical sense. I'm not paying attention to the game at all. Okay, let's see. There's only one Punch-Out character. They should have more. I don't mind that they don't have more Punch-Out characters because Punch-Out is a smaller series. You can represent the basis of Punch-Out with just Little Mac. Although if they did add more Punch-Out characters, one, I totally wouldn't be opposed. Because besides Smash Brothers, Punch-Out is pretty much my favorite series. And if they did add more Punch-Out characters, my top candidates would be like Bald Bull, King Hippo, and Doc Lewis. I think Bald Bull's been my favorite. I've made arguments with that before. A lot of people tell me like, what King Hippo is a better choice. And I'm like, no way. Bald Bull is the best choice for a second Punch-Out character. But I wouldn't mind if they did like the Pit Palutena thing and had Little Mac Doc Lewis. If you're looking for a rep just for Skyward Sword, your best option is Groose. I mean, come on, at the end of the game there, we see that, like, Link, Zelda, and Groose are, like, this trio of heroes, and yet we were throwing an Impa, and no one ever even considers Groose? What's up with that? I wonder if they've had any new updates on, that Hyrule Warriors 3D and what new characters they're gonna be, because we know that Tetra and King Daphnis, Snowhanson, Hyrule are gonna be characters, but I'm pretty sure they announced there would be more other characters besides them, so I wonder if they've said anything on that since the Direct. Like I said, I'm kind of out of the loop because I've been gone for a week, and a week without internet just means you're going to be behind. So there's like a lot of things that I don't know now, like that there was water right there, and now I'm dead. Groose doesn't have much going for him. Groose invented the Groosinator. Here's what you do. You give Ganondorf his own original moveset, and then you make Groose the Captain Falcon clone using Ganondorf's old moves. That's what you do. Also, I do like the idea, too. It's an idea I've heard a lot of having, like, Pig Ganon as his own character fighting with the Trident, like from Link to the Past. I think that's a really cool idea, also. Oh, man, we're getting to some big Legend of Zelda character debates on the chat here. Well, it's mainly Xant versus Ghirahim, but still. I like them both, but I'm on Team Xant. Also, I'm mainly joking about Groose. Even though I do like Groose a lot, I do think, in seriousness, that Ghirahim would be a better choice if you're looking for an arbitrary character who premiered in Skyward Sword character. And I see that, you know, you didn't add Xant, but you have Midna, who is definitely the best arbitrary Twilight Princess character. But, I mean, if you're throwing in characters just for the sake of they came from that game, then, you know, then it's like, okay, well, where's our arbitrary Ocarina of Time character? Where's our arbitrary Link to the Past character? Where, you know what I mean? You just start building that system. It's like people who are like, oh, you gotta have a Pokemon in each from each generation. It's like, where do you draw the line? Because, like, eventually we're gonna have so many Pokemon generations. And they've never gone off the philosophy you need to have one for every generation. It's always been, if you're looking at Super Smash Brothers, it's always first-gen Pokemon plus Pokemon from the newest generation. That every single Pokemon choice has been that. Pikachu, Charizard, Jigglypuff, and Mewtwo are all well-known Pokemon from the first generation. And, you know, that makes sense to have Pokemon from the first generation featured because they've been there the longest and still featured the most, you know, dominantly because they've been there the longest. Then Every other Pokemon choice has just been, you know, flavor of the newest generation. Pichu was in second generation. Lucario was in fourth generation. Greninja was in sixth generation. So, I really don't care about, you know, repping based off of game. That's why it's never bothered me that the Legend of Zelda selection is just Link, Zelda, Ganondorf. It's like, okay, well, that's the main trio. Good job. If you're going to have extras, then yeah, I do think you should go for the ones like Impa or Tingle or Tetra that have, you know, a consistent role in the series. But there are other individuals that I really like Majora's Mask Skull Kid. If we're just talking about characters that I find interesting and would love to be able to play as, that's probably my number one, is Majora's Mask Skull Kid. Although, like I said, between balancing everything out, I've always advocated for Tetra as the next Legend of Zelda character. But I also like the idea of, like, Demon Pig Ganondorf as his own playable character in Link to the Past style with the Trident. I think that would be really neat and really symbolic. Plus, then you finally get a Legend of Zelda villain fighting like a Legend of Zelda villain, because Ganondorf still fights like Captain Falcon. It's a much more unique Captain Falcon than back in Melee, but it's still a Captain Falcon rather than a Legend of Zelda villain. It's unnecessary to have three Links. Yes, but it's also unnecessary to have Marth, Lucina, and Roy. You know what I mean? I don't mind them returning young Link, purely from the sake of the fact that he is a veteran now. You know, what's done is done. I don't mind if it's like, oh, if they want to add back in Roy and Pichu and Dr. Mario, because even if they are redundant characters, they are veterans at this point. So, you know, here's me saying it's like, why add these arbitrary characters just for that sake? Well, I mean, if you are going for like, oh, some big Ultimate Smash Brothers game, then yeah, I think it's okay to make the room for everyone who's already been a character. Let's bring back Squirtle and Ivysaur, too. Or, I don't know, a lot of people like replacing Ivysaur with Bulbasaur, and I mean, I guess that works just as well. But if you're going to go with that, then you might as well say that Toon Link already replaced Young Link, and it's pretty much the same thing. So, I don't know, that kind of seems redundant. If you're going to say, oh, we'll replace Ivysaur with Bulbasaur, but we're going to have both Toon Link and Young Link, I don't know. I don't know. Sakurai making a bad choice in Fire Emblem Reps doesn't mean we should repeat a bad choice in another series. Yeah, I guess not. Especially when there's other good reps. What Fire Emblem characters... I mean, I don't know. I think we have plenty of Fire Emblem characters now. We got Marth, Ike, Robin. I'm not even going to count Lucina. she was just thrown in. Whatever comes next is really going to depend on how many Fire Emblem games. Because, I mean, obviously they could add Kamui from Fates. But if there's another Fire Emblem game before the next Super Smash Bros. Game, then that whoever the main character of that next one is probably going to take priority. You know, kind of like how they didn't add a 5th gen Pokemon, they just added Greninja. You know? So, I mean, Kamui seems pretty cool. You got, what, swords, tomes, and can turn into a dragon? That sounds like a Smash Brothers character right there, but if something else comes out before then, well, then that's that. I don't think they're going to go back for anything else, you know what I mean? I don't think they're going to go back and add, like, Crom or Black Knight or, who else? Sigurd, Harden, Leaf. I don't think they're going to go back and add older characters at this point, but I don't know. Unless one of those games gets a remake, then maybe. There are so many good choices for Fire Emblem characters, it doesn't make sense for him to just keep adding the protagonists. It's kind of the same... Oh, wow, they got three rulers. It's kind of the same as, like, the Mother series, you know what I mean? I mean, Fire Emblem's way bigger, but the only Mother characters we've seen have been Ness and Lucas. And not only are they the main protagonists, they're also, like, they're like the main psychic users. I mean, There's some really interesting villains, first off, in the Mother series. Plus, you always have, like, a companion who does something other than psychic abilities, or, like, two. I mean, Earthbound has Pooh, who's a karate master, and the original Mother has Teddy, who's, like, a big gangster with knives, and, Mother 3 has Duster and Flint. I mean, there's a lot of great characters you could add, but the problem is that just there's so many, like, differences between the games that it's like, okay, well, we have to have the protagonist of this game. You know what I mean? It's like, I think they're and I can see where they're coming from. I think their idea is that if they're going to have villains, they also have to have all the main protagonists that go with them. You know what I mean? They can't add an antagonist unless they have all the protagonist that correlates to it. And because they keep coming out with new Fire Emblem games with new protagonists, they feel like they have to have the new protagonists come in, right? Like, let's say, like, okay, the original, that Melee had Marth in it. So, like, maybe if they did more games with just Marth, or there hadn't been anything else new since then maybe when Brawl came out, they would have one of Marth's villains playable. But that's not the case. There was a new Fire Emblem game with a new protagonist. So, like, okay, well, we gotta add Ike as the new protagonist. But then it's like, okay, a lot of people actually did want Zelgius playable, or others, because it's like, well, Ike's in there, we could have his villain, and that would be really cool, and it would be, but they didn't, because it's like, okay, well, we already have Ike, so we don't need to add anything else, because Ike is enough. And then so then by the time the next game comes around, Smash 4, it's like, well, we could go back and add a Marth villain or an Ike villain. But, I mean, we need to have an Awakening character, which I do think they did. And so that they have Robin. And let's say Lucina doesn't really count, because she was kind of thrown in for other... Because, like Dr. Mario, it's like, oh, she was going to be a costume, and then they wound up having the space and the time, and that's how that all worked. But, yeah, no, it makes sense they have Robin, so then what? They could have a villain from Awakening, but it's like, well, what's the point? At that point, because we already have Robin, so it's just kind of that perpetual cycle. And then, you know, thinking about it, from what I know about Fates and from playing Fire Emblem Awakening, I wouldn't want the villains of those games playable. Zelgius and Hardin seem like way better choices if you're gonna go with villains. They can just add the protagonist and antagonist at the same time. I think that'd be great, but they never do. I mean, we're still missing Ridley and K. Rool from our villain lineup. What makes you think they're gonna bleed that into Fire Emblem? It's a great idea, and I like it. I just don't see it actually happening. I think what they've done makes sense, and even though I would desire it to be done differently, it means cutting things in other areas that I like. Like, if they were going to add all these other villains, it means they probably have to, in my mind, they probably have to cut out having, like, the extra characters, like Wii Fit Trainer and stuff like that, which at face value I don't mind, but I like having those surprises. You know, I don't just, it's a weird thing, I don't just want to have the characters that I want, I also want to have the characters that I wasn't expecting, because, I don't know, if I just have the characters that I want, then it's... You know, it's like I did make the game. It's not like, oh, wow, this is amazing. It's like, oh, wow, this is exactly what I wanted. And those are two different things. It's hard for me to put into words. At least Robin isn't entirely the protagonist. You can make an argument that he's simultaneously the antagonist. Marth, Villager, and Samus versus Fox, Pit, and Mr. Game & Watch. We already established that by Death Battle rules, Fox can have his R-Wing, which means Samus can also have her Starship. So I'm going to go with Fox, Pit, and Mr. Game & Watch, because Pit can use the ultimate sacred treasure. You know what does need a villain? Kid Icarus, bring us Hades. So there's two sides to that for me. For one, I don't think Kid Icarus is big enough to warrant as many characters as it already has. But on the flip side, Hades is an amazing character, and I would love to see him in Super Smash Bros. So I would totally be down for them adding Hades. When was the last time I actually fought Team Hot Dog? So I've reached that point where I'm not even paying attention to the game. I'm just commenting on chat. Oh, so I said I saw two shows in Vegas. The other show I saw in Vegas was Blue Man Group, which is just an absolute riot. They are hilarious, and they are a ton of fun. Like, oh my gosh, I can't remember the last time I laughed that hard and had, like, it felt like a party. Like, had that much fun. So, oh my gosh, it was hard for me to decide what I liked more between Blue Man Group and Ka, because Ka was just super-duper impressive. Like, the scope of everything was so massive. But, oh my god, Blue Man Group was just so fun. It was amazing. I probably like Blue Man Group more. Just because I had so much fun. Haha! I thought he was about to jump off the edge there. Gotcha. Oh, there's a bugger up there. I seriously called... That was my first choice? Bugger? I'm not even British. Oh, man. Oop. Really? I died? Oh. Looks like we're doing pretty well. I don't have very many points because there's not much turf to cover because we've already covered it all. Oh, wait. There's someone up here. Well, let's start cleaning up their mess. They left all this green snot everywhere. Let's go clean it up. Ha, he thinks he's covering the turf, but in actuality, I'm already covering it up. I don't know how he got up there so fast, but now he's dead. So like my normal Splatfest streams, we'll stream until we're king, do a match as a king, and then we'll call it quits. But I have a feeling Team Marshmallow is going to win, because as long as we keep fighting each other, we keep winning. Unless that doesn't count. I don't know how they decide that. Like, it's like, okay, Team Marshmallow won the most matches, but that's because they kept fighting Team Marshmallow. So do those also count as losses? Do losses even count? I don't know. Do they just count as neutral because they balance out? I have no idea how the statistics work on this, but apparently there is way more people on Team Marshmallow. Which doesn't surprise... It almost surprises me, but it doesn't quite surprise me. Just as a side note, my roster is not made to look like it's for the next Smash. I don't think it'll be... Oh, yeah, no, it's a dream roster. I totally get it. Like, one of my second video I ever did on YouTube was like a 100-character dream Smash roster. And then people were like, there's no way they'll have that many characters next time. And I'm like, well, fine, I'll make one for, like, what they could do next time. And that's when I started getting into the Smash 4 speculation stuff. So, there's another part of that story. That I do. 6 kills, not bad. Hey, I'm a marshmallow defender now! If by defending them you mean, like, stuffing them in my face. Pizza! Hello! Hello, Shulk90. Who is all on the chat anyway? Spiny Bowser, Lord Jackal, Smash Master, Shulk90. I know the winged ass was on here earlier. Holyman003. I never did, like, a big hello to everybody. Gilbert Spider! Yay! What I realized was that the problem in making a giant Dream Smash roster was that then new games come out and you're like, oh, I want a character from that game. You know, I know Codename Steam wasn't a giant success, but I would still love to see, like, either Harry Fleming or Abraham Lincoln in Smash Brothers, just because I think it'd be funny. I mean, back when I did that, my 100-character roster, like, a lot of characters didn't even exist. And so I had characters on there that, like, I wouldn't even think about now. Like,
I think my 100 character one had like Spyro and Lara Croft on it. I wouldn't even bother in a 100 character roster putting them on there anymore. I think I had Scorpion too for Mortal Kombat. Did I? No, I didn't. I did have Ryu though. I did have Ryu, and now Ryu is there. I thought maybe I could make that jump. I cannot. There are no shortcuts in this map. You gotta play it straight. It is so pink over here. I'm gonna jump to Fred. All right, Fred, you are where the action is. That's where I want to be. Action land. All right.
Hey, love.
Yes, sweetie.
Guess what I almost did with the chicken this time around?
What did you almost do with the chicken this time around?
Remember how I had to buy more rosemary?
Yeah. Did you almost dump the entire bottle of rosemary in the chicken?
Yes.
Again?
Yes. I caught myself.
Well, it's a good thing you stopped. I don't want to go out and buy another rosemary when we just bought one yesterday.
Really expensive.
Yes, rosemary is expensive. Still not as bad as saffron, though. Nothing's as bad as saffron.
Do you know why it's expensive, though?
Do you?
Yeah.
Because I don't know the reason. Why is saffron so expensive?
You know how plants can both, like, reproduce through, either planting a stem of it or through sexual reproduction.
Right.
There is only one, like, I guess DNA strand for that plant because there's no way you can sexually reproduce it.
So it doesn't reproduce as easily or as often.
Nope. It's kind of like how bananas are, where pretty much all your bananas are not sexually reproductive. They're pretty much just, like, copies of one plant.
Right.
So yeah, that's pretty much why saffron's so expensive, not only because, you know, it grows in really, like, difficult conditions, but also it only comes from one original plant.
That makes sense. So, that as to why it's so expensive then.
Yeah. Isn't that sad?
It is.
It's because people, like, loved it so much that they pretty much almost wiped it out to extinction.
Oh, that's how it happened.
Something like that could happen.
Unless it's always been that way.
No.
Okay.
The plant wouldn't survive on
one strand of DNA?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I was so sure Hot Dog was going to win until I watched the stream and just saw how outnumbered. Yeah, it is massive how outnumbered Hot Dog is. It's incredible. Annabrew Crossing, hi! Hello there, Annabrew Crossing. I hope I'm saying your name close enough to write. But hello, welcome to the stream. Thank you for watching. I don't know how to use the brush. I like the brushes a lot, but I just love how quickly you can destroy opponents and cover turf with rollers. But I do like the brushes quite a bit, too.
No plants for Rosie today.
Isaac, if you're down to play tomorrow morning, we're going to practice. We can figure out a strategy for the tournament. I think I already... We'll see. I already promised to play tomorrow with Rex, Lance, and Seth. Because Lance and Rex got the game now. So the four of us could, like, do something. Am I going to be on, like, two different four-man squads? It's like I'm going to be on Longview Squad and New York Squad. Except Brady's not from New York either, is he? Or is Brady from New York? I have no clue. Or Brian, even. So maybe Chris is the only one from New York. Oh, we're playing with Zorark!
I didn't know that Pokemon could play that stuff.
If anyone cares, you can check out my roster on DeviantArt. Okay. Open in new window.
I love DeviantArt.
The Ultimate Super Smash Brothers roster. What else is in here? Medusa, good. Captain Syrup. That's a good one. Magalore, Bandana Waddledee, Prince Fluff, Suikapon, Sceptile, Slippy. If you're gonna have Slippy, you gotta have Peppy too. Don't leave Peppy out of the action. I'll get back to it after this fight, or maybe during. Besides, Peppy, like, his side B or his up B can be barrel roll. It'd be perfect. He could say it while he's doing it, too. Do a barrel roll! You can't leave that out, man. You can't have Fox, Falco, and Slippy and then not have Peppy. I love the rapid fire weapons also. I haven't practiced with anything besides rollers and brushes, so I really suck with them. Well, besides, I mean, I'm okay with like the basic splatter shot since it's what you have to use in hero mode. And I did beat hero mode, so I guess I know how to use that weapon. But my favorite weapons are the melee weapons, because that's just what I do in any game I play. I just like the, I don't know, more than anything, I think I just like the concept. I just like, oh yeah, this is a game where everyone uses guns, so I'm going to use the not gun. I kind of like the buckets, now that I know that there's buckets. That's pretty funny. That's really funny. I might give this a whirl sometime. I need to do more Splatoon streams, because now, well, now there's the private battles for one, but for two, now there's just so much more stuff in this game. Now it feels like a complete game. Before it was like, oh yeah, this is going to be a cool game. Now it's like, oh man, now it is a cool game. Hello there. My name is Kraken. Craig McCracken. I'm not actually Craig McCracken. But he's a pretty cool guy. Oh shit. Bree's been practicing with buckets. Alright, cool. Maybe I'll add Peppy to the roster? Okay. I have to look at what else is on that roster when I can. Isaac? Agnes? No! I mean, I like Agnes a lot. But if you're going to have Agnes, Tiz is better, I think. I'd rather, if we're in a fighting game, I'd rather play as Tiz than Agnes.
Unacceptable!
Because, I mean, Agnes isn't even playable in Bravely Default 2, but Tiz is. And Tiz is the warrior. Agnes is pretty much the white mage.
Unacceptable.
I'm going to jump. Let's jump to Zorark.
She's wearing a summoner outfit, which is very unfitting for her.
Is that what you did?
You see the outfit that she was in when you were watching me play?
Oh, that's the summoner outfit?
Yeah.
The outfit itself is unfitting for her?
Yeah, it's very scantily clad.
As scantily clad as that game gets.
Yeah. But, I mean, Agnes is very modest.
Oh, yeah. That's why she exposes her shoulders in the official art for the music.
Well, that's just her, like, traditional gown made by a very pervy man.
Let's see here. Ness, Lucas, Klaus, Shulk, Fiora. I wouldn't have thought of Fiora. All right. Wonder Red, Inkling, Takamaru, Mock Rider, Taboo, Rayman, Black Mage, Shovel Knight. All right. Looks pretty solid. Like I said, the only things that really bother me are having Peppy but not having Slippy. And I really do like Tiz more than Agnes for Smash Brothers.
Why not Ring a Bell?
Ring a Bell!
Ring a Bell!
I know Ring a Bell's your favorite.
It's fabulous. A little bit too pervy, but fabulous.
Alright. That was before I played Bravely Default and thought Agnes was the main character. Agnes is like the poster boy character, even though she's a girl.
Poster girl.
You know what I mean? Which is essentially... Oh, connection has been lost.
She is necessary for the first game.
Is someone calling me?
Mm-hmm.
Who is calling me? Oh, it's either my brother or my parents. Hello? Hey, Seth, what's up? Yep, I'm streaming right now. Say hello to the internet. Yeah. Say hi.
Come on speakerphone.
All right, so what's up? Oh, okay, well, you can try to get involved. I am on Team Marshmallow. Okay. Well, yeah, but you can't form a team on Splatfest, so we're thinking about doing that tomorrow, if you're free tomorrow. Okay. Maybe. I don't know for sure. Also, I'm pretty sure Team Marshmallow is winning, Seth.
Marshmallow?
Neither did Chris, but Seth, I'm playing Team Marshmallow, and more than half my battles have been against other Team Marshmallow people, because there's not enough people on Team Hot Dog. Can you hold this phone up to my face? Yes, that's happened more than half the time, is me fighting other Marshmallow teams.
I am holding the phone up to my husband's face.
Whoa, that person has a sedge hat. That's awesome. I want a sedge hat. A sedge hat. It's a Chinese hat.
It's, isn't it more Vietnamese?
Vietnamese? Yeah, Vietnamese Korean. Hat.
Yeah.
Or Korean.
Can I just take this phone to your face?
All right, Seth, I gotta go for now because I'm streaming. And also Rosie's holding up the phone while I'm playing. Bye, talk to you tomorrow. That's my brother. That's my brother. He was in the Mario Party 2 versus. What else? He was in something else, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm.
What else was he in?
I don't know.
Fortune Street. The Family Fortune Street game.
Family Fortune Street.
What if there was a Fortune Street game show? Hooray! Double kill! And whoever's shooting at me is horrible aim.
Banana tastes good.
Because I'm able to slowly roll away from them.
Slowly roll away.
Ah! See, this is the thing I love about the roller. You can't just run over somebody with the paintbrush. You can. I can just casually walk into somebody and kill them. Okay, I need to put this other earphone back in my ear and then read all these comments. Sex is like pizza. When it's good, it's good. When it's bad, it's still pretty good. I will agree with that sentiment, except for, in my life, I have had one absolutely awful pizza. And I have never had a bad sex.
You have me to thank for that. That was really easy to fuck up a pizza.
It's really easy to fuck up sex.
It is, too. You just gotta be a dick about it, and then, yeah. Kind of for people.
I went Prince Fluffy, I went Mario, huh, it's disgusting. Yeah. My brother is Liquid Snake. Does he sound like Liquid Snake? I never thought about it. I'm playing against Stormtroopers. Pretty much. No, seriously, I want a Sedge hat, though. I always thought Sedge hats were really cool. Like, I love it when fictional characters wear Sedge hats. I can't even explain why, I just think it looks cool.
Oh my god, Isaac.
What?
So, I'm looking through this list of ironic tattoos. There's this guy in the hospital with a knife through his face.
Oh, man, I thought we were doing so well.
It says, hard to kill. Isn't that funny?
Tell me more about sedge hats or about sex? Because we already talked about sex a lot on the last, like, stream I did. How does one mess up sex? You go too fast.
You treat the person like shit.
You
do something dangerous that horribly injures yourself, like using knives.
You
don't wear a condom.
Well, I mean, that depends.
Well, if you have AIDS, it really ruins sex for you.
Okay, so STDs ruin
STDs.
Sex.
Well,
you know, food poisoning can ruin pizza, though.
Food poisoning can ruin sex if you barf all over the person.
God damn it.
Getting arrested while having sex.
What if they want to be treated like shit? Then that's
consensual. Like, that's kind of like...
That's consensual treating like shit.
As long as it's consensual, then, you know, most things are kind of okay as long as you don't do anything that can kill them.
Oh, Chris had to add hypothetically. Because, you know, we don't already all know that Chris loves being treated like shit in his relationships.
Oh, ouch.
Sorry.
But, you know, if you go with the rules of BDSM, if you don't keep it safe, if you don't keep it sane...
Oh, hey, Rex is on. Hey there, Rex.
Then you fuck up.
Cypher. Surprise butt sex might ruin it. Surprise butt sex enhances it.
Surprise sex in general is kind of a problem unless you've mentioned before with your partner that you're okay with it. Once again, if you keep it safe, keep it sane, keep it consensual, you usually don't have to end up fucking it up.
STDs are the food poisoning of sex.
Sometimes literally.
Wait, what if it's consensual, then are you really treating them like shit? No, it's kind of acting, I guess?
It's like you're pretending to treat them like shit. But you really don't mean to treat them like shit.
I like Kool-Aids. Kool-Aids are delicious.
Haha! Your inch strike means nothing, but you still killed me anyway. Oh man.
Wow, I actually have two mods on chat for once. Sometimes I can't even get one. I don't think Rune342 has ever watched or modded a single stream. We specifically, when I first started streaming, we specifically set up stream times so that he could always watch me stream. And he, I don't think he has ever watched me stream. Unless he's with you right now there, Rex. In which I tell him I am not sorry about my comment at all, because it is absolutely true. Except for right now. Oh, me and this guy are just totally tearing the field up here. Where is the enemy at? Oh, they're at our base, doing the exact same thing that we're doing. Come back here, you!
They're messing up our base.
Messing up our base.
Our base.
Okay, I gotta stay alive long enough to... Okay, well, that guy died. I'm reached the top of the tower! I'm the king of the blues!
Also, today is my grandpa's birthday.
Your grandpa's birthday? Oh. Your, Grandpa Armstrong?
Yep.
Okay.
I only have one living grandpa.
Right. That's what I couldn't... I was trying to think of, like, your grandpa on your dad's side, and I'm like, wait, that, I don't even know that person.
No, he had 3 heart attacks and died on the 3rd.
Wow, that's impressive.
He was kind of a badass in that regard.
Right. Didn't he drive himself to the hospital while having the 3 heart attacks?
The first 2 times he drove himself to the hospital.
Jesus.
In the middle of the heart attack.
During the heart attack, yeah.
During the heart attack.
He is a bit of a badass. Oh my god.
Yep.
How are we doing this match anyway?
Unless you're my dad.
Your dad doesn't have any?
Yeah, he's been very prompt about checking it because he's reaching the same age my grandpa was when he passed away.
Oh, that makes sense then.
But, you know, he went to, like, a
I think we lost, but I did good.
He went to, a legit cardiologist in Seattle and did all the testing he could, and his heart's okay.
Lord Jackal is not Coogie. He's making that up. It's Chris London, which I don't know if you've ever met Chris, but he was, one of the groomsmen at my wedding.
And he's a fun guy. All your friends are fun guys. Or fun girls. You have great friends.
Yep. 1v1 me? I'll 1v1 you in a little bit here, Rex. You know what? I'll get off of this and I'll 1v1 you after this match.
Mm, the chicken smells good, love.
Can we actually 1v1? You two have met? Okay, I couldn't remember. Okay, I couldn't remember. I could not remember.
Okay,
so 375. All right. Sure is taking a while to find opponents. Who wants to bet me $20 it's going to be Team Marshmallow? You met Rex before you met me?
What?
Really? I had no clue.
It's a small world after all.
You bullied me? You did not bully me into getting this game. I pre-ordered it. Chris, did you seriously meet Rex before me? I had no idea. Because I didn't meet Rex until, like, after I was already in college. You had mutual friends? Okay. You did not bully me into pre-ordering it. I had planned to order pre-order Splatoon from the beginning.
Oh,
It's a small world, it really is. I've had plenty of small world moments in my life.
Ooh. You should tell them about the small world moment we had in Vegas.
The one with my dad?
That one, and the, whole thing that your parents are friends with my elementary school music teacher.
Oh, I guess that's true. Yeah, what happened is, I'm a music teacher, and my parents are music teachers, or at least my dad's a music teacher. And so my parents' best friends are two other music teachers in our district. One of those music teachers was my wife's elementary school music teacher. So they came on the trip to Vegas with us. It was me and Rosie and my parents and this other couple that like I said, are my parents' best friends that are also music teachers. And so Rosie was just kind of like, wow, I never thought, when I was a kid that I'd be one day going to Vegas with my elementary school music teacher. It is kind of funny.
It is. It's really weird. Well, it's also weird because, you're friends with my other elementary school music teachers.
I'm friends with all the music teachers because they're just family friends.
So it's just weird to think, okay, let's say I go to myself in middle school and say, hey, you're going to marry someone who's close friends with your orchestra teacher or something like that. With all your orchestra teachers, but pretty much. It's really weird.
Okay.
But cool.
Rex, did you send me a friend request so that we can 1v1? Oh, shit! Damn it! I should have just kept rolling. You're at work right now, Chris? You're on here doing work? You did? Okay. I'll accept your friend request after this match and we can dojo it up. If that's how it works. Dojo! Dojo.
Do they have a JoJo dub?
A JoJo dub? I don't think they do, but maybe they do. I don't remember.
I don't want to watch it.
Well, even if you don't watch the dub,
I want to keep to one sub at a time, you know me.
Oh, right. It's like, what are you subbing right now? It's like, oh yeah, we're watching Ore Monogatari. That's
Which
right.
It's been really cute.
Yeah.
I don't know if I like it as much as Clannad, though. It's really hard to like anything.
It's hard to like anything more than Clan.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I just tripped. Yep. Oh, my God. Isaac, what, I know what we should cosplay if we go to a convention.
What should we cosplay?
Inklings.
We should cosplay as Inklings?
You be boy, I be girl.
Why can't I be girl and you can be boy?
Well, you can be girl and I can be boy. We can cross-dress. That'll be fun.
Okay. Alright.
I want to be an Inkling.
Nope.
Or we can both be girls and be adorable little lesbians together.
Okay, so I need to accept Rex's friend request.
Do you want to be a lesbian Inkling?
Yes, I've always wanted to be a lesbian Inkling. My whole life. C grand? Was C for already taken?